Hey everyone, I'm DJ Spiess, and in this video, we're going to talk about how to send data between two view controllers using Swift 2.0. The code in this video uses Swift 2.0 and iOS 9. It may or may not work on other versions. Swift is a moving target, but hopefully with Swift 2.0, the dust is starting to settle. What we're going to do for this app is to have the user select a color on a second screen. On the main screen, we'll display the color the user selected. On the secondary screen, the user can select between red, green, or blue. We'll also let the user know what color was selected before. The data passed from the first screen to the second screen is what color was previously selected. We'll pass that data directly. The data passed from the second screen to the first screen is the color the user selected. We'll pass it back using delegation. It's a simple app, but the app we're creating demonstrates how data is moved in both directions. Here's what we have. We start with the two view controllers in our storyboard, both embedded in a navigation controller. The source code for this app is available on GitHub if you want to follow along. On the start view, we have a subview that's displaying the color using the background color property. That's the currently selected color. And we have a button that takes us to the destination view. The destination view has three buttons, one for the three selectable colors. We also have a label to display what color was selected before. We'll segue from the start view controller when the user presses the button. We'll control click to add a segue from the button to the destination view. We'll just use show as a segue type and the name identifier as pick color segue. This gets us to the destination view. The destination view needs to display what was selected before, so we need to add code to pass the value of the previously selected color. To pass information to the destination view, we add the code to prepare for segue. Prepare for segue is the method called before we transition to the next view. This method allows us to pass information from the current view to the next. The segue object holds a reference to the view we're segueing to. The property is destination view controller. Now, it would be nice if we could set the label value directly on the destination view controller, but the label outlet is not hooked up when we call prepare for segue. We need to add a property on the destination view to hold the value until we can update the label text. We'll then use that value in the viewDidLoad method on the destination view controller to set the label. Well, that's pretty easy. It gets a bit trickier to send data back. To return data from a modal dialog, or if you're popping views like we need to with a navigation controller, we need to use the delegate pattern. The basics of the delegation pattern is we call another object to perform the action we need. We delegate the action, and the class we delegate to performs the action. In our case, instead of destination view setting the values on the start view controller, we'll delegate that action to the delegate class. The reason we do it this way is because the destination view should have no knowledge of the start view. This way, we could use the destination view in other places in our application. If that wasn't clear, let me know in the comments below. Here's the fun part. We create a protocol with one method that communicates any information we need. In our case, we'll create a protocol with one method called setColor. This protocol is defined in our destination view. If we had more information, we could add methods or create a struct to hold all the data we needed to pass. We'll create a property for that delegate, and whenever someone selects a color, we'll tell the delegate the selected color. So, who gets to be the delegate? The calling view controller, of course. So we'll make start view controller the delegate. So in this case, the start view controller and the delegate are the same. When we call prepare for segue, we'll set the delegate property to self. Then we make sure the start view controller conforms to the protocol by adding the set color method. In the set color method, we'll set the background color of the subview to the color we've selected. To return to the calling view, we'll create events for when a user presses a button. In the event, we'll call setColor, and then we'll pop off back to the root view controller. That's the start view controller in this case. We're not referencing start view controller directly, so we can call this from other places in our app if we need to.
And that's how we pass data between iOS views using Swift 2.0. We pass information to the second view using the prepare for segue method, and then we pass information back to the calling view using the delegate pattern. It's important to note the delegate pattern examples usually use the calling view controller as a delegate, but that's not always desirable. You might have one class holding the state for your application, and that would serve as the delegate. It depends on what you're trying to accomplish. Any class that conforms to the protocol can be the delegate. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. If you like this video, like and share. Liking helps attract more views. New videos come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. You don't want to miss a video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.